William and Kate are doing one thing right as parents that Harry and Meghan aren't. The Duke and Duchess of Cambridge and the Duke and Duchess of Sussex are all fairly new parents. Parenting is hard, and there often isn't one right or wrong answer to how to do it. It depends on the situation and environment, and every mother and father differ in the way they choose to raise their kids. But there is one thing Kate and William seem to be doing more than Meghan and Harry, and it could make a difference in their children's lives in the long run. Both couples have had to learn how to parent in the spotlight. Being a new parent isn't easy for anyone. But parenting with everyone watching only makes things even more complicated. When William and Kate announced their first pregnancy, people were obsessed with Kate's every move, every outfit she wore, every food she ate, and more. People wanted to know what she was doing all the time. And when she finally gave birth, people couldn't wait to see what kind of parents she and William would be. Things were no different for Meghan and Harry. From the moment Meghan announced a pregnancy, people became obsessed with her maternity style and wanted to know her and Harry's plans for raising Archie. In the midst of trying to learn how to be a mother and father, the royals were also trying to balance immense fame. Kate is always socializing her children by bringing them to various royal events. Kate and William attend many royal events together, but there are also times when the kids accompany Kate to events where their father is either not present or attending the event in a different form. For example, Kate brought the kids to watch their father's charity polo match, alongside Meghan and Archie, and let the kids run around for most of the time. She also brought Charlotte up in front of a huge crowd at the King's Cup regatta, though Charlotte then stuck her tongue out and sent everyone into a hilarious tizzy. But Meghan hasn't been so inclined to show her son the royal life. Meghan and Harry have kept Archie extremely sheltered. Meghan and Harry are doing their best to raise Archie as a private citizen, and who can blame them? With all of the negative press they've received, there isn't anything wrong with wanting to shelter their son from the same thing. However, keeping Archie too sheltered from his true royal ties might not be good for him either. At the polo match with Kate and her kids, Meghan was never photographed without Archie in her hands. She carried him for the entire day, preventing him from playing with his cousins. And there have hardly been any instances of Meghan and Harry allowing their young son to socialize with other family members. We never hear about Archie spending time with others or even leaving Windsor Castle to spend time with his cousins, for that matter. Not allowing Archie to socialize could do more harm than good. Meghan and Harry are likely apprehensive about bringing Archie into the spotlight after everything they've been through, but not allowing him to develop social relationships, even at such a young age, could be detrimental. Though Archie is young, Meghan and Harry appear to be on a path that will keep him from spending much time with those around him. And as he grows, his social habits will play an even larger role in his life. With Harry and William at odds and very few close friends allowed around the royal family, it's becoming concerning that the Sussexes aren't opening more doors for their son to interact with the world. William and Kate allowed the press to attend George and Charlotte's first day of school, which is important, since the kids need to adjust to growing up in the spotlight and might as well start young. Hopefully Meghan and Harry will expose their son to the royal way of life sooner rather than later, or he could have trouble developing those skills later in life.